break a flake. We're going to see how much force is required to break one of these. You will need some pencils with a bit of blue tack. You'll see why the blue tack's there in a minute. A ruler to measure the width of these things. Some scales to measure the force required to break them. And something to jot down the results. So let's take some of these. It's useful if we have a nice flat one. We're going to measure the width of it. That's going to be the independent variable. That's the thing that we change. And there we go. Take a note of that. Let's now build our force testing rig. The force is going to be the dependent variable, which is dependent on the width, I hope. We're going to put these together so that you can fit another pencil in between. Pop that on there and switch it on. We now let the thing zero. And then start applying the force really, really gently at first and gently more and more until it breaks. Be really careful about noting exactly the point at which it breaks. And we write that down. Now, the results here are in kilograms. And we need to multiply this by a factor of 10 to get newtons. Okay? Now let's do this loads and loads more times. Gather as many data as you possibly can, because we'd like you to submit them to us, the width of your flake and the amount of force in newtons required to break them. What do you do with these results? Get loads of them and share them with us. This is citizen science. We're going to collect them together and generate more information about breaking points of flakes than anybody has ever done before.
Yay!
Good measurement practice. It's really, really important whenever you're doing any sort of measurement to jot down the circumstances. Normally you'd think about the temperature, the humidity, things like that. This time, the most important thing we'd like you to record the type of flake, whether it's a corn flake or a bran flake or one of those frosted flakes. That's the extra piece of information. So we have to say thank you very much indeed to Vivian Tong, who's a research engineer at NPL, who came up with this idea for this test. And she does these sort of tests all day, every day, although evidently not with bran flakes. She does it with zirconian alloys, which are then used in nuclear power stations. So thanks very much, Vivian, and we look forward to getting your results.